Video, it's going to be on magnetic deficiency syndrome. I call this MDS. And not too many people have heard about magnetic deficiency syndrome, okay? Because, well, it's not really understood magnetism. Okay, remember, everything is magnetism. Everything is magnetism, as you'll find out. Okay, so if everything is magnetism, I think it would be very smart to go ahead and add magnetism to our bodies, because most of us have this phenomena called magnetic deficiency syndrome. And how do you get it? Okay, swimming around electricity, swimming around radio frequencies, swimming around Wi-Fi, or what I call Wi-Fi, okay? All the different things that you come in contact with that aren't natural take away your magnetism. And when you eat cooked food, that takes away your magnetism, okay? When you listen to music that is not harmonious, you get into a fight with someone, you have anger, okay? Do you think that helps your magnetism? No, it actually destroys it. So magnetism is very important, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna go over a variety of ways for you to be able to introduce magnetism, okay, into your world. And this has been super profound, not only for myself, okay, because I got into this is because I had a severe back problem. And once your bones actually calcify and ossify and they get hard, how do you get those unstuck? How do you get those uncalcified? How do you get arthritis, okay, which is calcificational spurs? How do you get kidney stones, okay? How do you get any of these poisonings called oxalate poisoning out of you? How do you get, if you have a pipe, okay, and I'm just gonna go through this just to connect the dots. If you have a pipe and it's filled full of debris, okay, how do you get rid of the debris? You put magnets on the pipe, don't you? You've heard of this. These are all patents. So what we're going to do is we're going to use magnetism in a variety of ways I'm going to show you to be able to soften the body. And this is going to cause, well, every injury that you've had probably to resurface. So it's not going to make you feel the greatest in the beginning, but in time, okay, I've been using this for 5 years straight, and this has probably helped me with my back problem with regeneration massively. And we're going to show you a variety of ways to be able to use magnetism towards your benefit. Now, Beatrice here is going to learn, just like Trevor, and these guys are advanced, okay? So when they use any of the things we're gonna show you here, to them, they're going to optimize very quickly. Now, let's say someone is 20 or 30 or 40 pounds overweight, okay? You're gonna have to go ahead and figure out how you're gonna use this, is because you're gonna probably end up having some side effects. And the side effects are you having diarrhea, headaches, dizziness, okay? Is because why? Because you're dissolving a lot of stuff. So you have to be careful how much you dissolve, how fast you can dissolve. So we've got a variety of different things on our table here, okay? And everything I have here has to do with not only using what we're gonna use, but complementing what we're gonna use. So real quick here, let's just go over some of the things we're doing. We're gonna make a magnetic mattress. And a magnetic mattress is for you, when you sleep, to be able to help dislodge a lot of calcifications in your system while you sleep. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. And this is, like I said, this is gonna be one of the most profound ways for you to be able to step up to the next layer. So not only do you have a magnetic mattress, but we're gonna also make some magnetic jars. So we're gonna use different magnetism for different jars, because different magnetism gives you different effects depending on the magnetism. Remember, everything is magnetism. So we're gonna use several different what we call conformities to the magnets. As you can see, when I put the magnets, let's just go over magnetism real quick here. These will just start. Okay, you can see if I let these go, they go together, okay? The north and the south pull together. That's how magnets work. These are about a 5,000 Gauss magnet, and this is what we're gonna use. We have these at Earthshift. These are domino magnets, and these are Trevor's right here, and he's smart because he put a piece of tape on his. Because if you snap these together, these can chip and go in your eye. I got a piece in my eye, and it took me about 2 years to get it out, and it really bothered me for a long time. Now, magnetism, if you turn the magnetism around, remember, this is a different field. We're going to show you three different fields to use here. On the magnetic mattress, we're going to use a multipolarity field. You never use singular fields on your body, and we're going to go over that. We're going to use biphasic field. Biphasic means we're going to use one side and the other side. So you can see, here, hold that, Beatrice, for me, so you can feel the difference. Now you notice, remember, you can't see what we're feeling. Excuse me, you can't feel what we're feeling, but you can see what we're feeling. See, she's pushing against us, and we can't touch as if we wanted to. That's how strong these magnets are. Now, she keeps hers like this, and I'm going to turn the polarity around, and now I'm going to have to hold back from the magnets wanting to kiss each other. Okay, and if I get them too close, okay, and then she has to break it apart by bending it. But if we pull just straight, they're really locked. So in order to break them apart, I have to sort of crack them. Okay, so here's the fields real quick. Here's one, okay, north, south. I'm showing you this here because we're going to mark the magnets, and you need to know this part in the beginning. If not, you're going to get confused, okay? Look, because remember, what we're using on all of what we're using is multipolarity. So here it is again. Like I said, these are strong. These are 5,000 Gauss. When you hook two together, you get multiplication. So now I have 10,000 Gauss. If I put three of these together on each side, you keep on multiplying them up. So you can actually add magnetism to anything we're doing, but I'm going to show you the basics because you got to start out with the basics. No matter what level you're at, because you will definitely go ahead and have side effects. And remember, the side effects are necessary when you have calcification. And side effects means that it sounds like it's bad, but it's not. The side effects you're going to get is going to just show you that it's working. And when you do get the side effects, you have to stop using the magnetism, okay? Because you don't want to unload too much. And I'll go over that a little later, too. So north, south, there's one. All we're going to do is turn it over this way. Either way, it doesn't matter, this way or this way. But we're just going to now have opposite fields. So let's say this is north and south. I flip this over. Now they're north and north, and they're fighting against each other. Now the last field, remember, north-south together, let's say north-north, and I'm gonna flip them one more time, and now they're south-south, three magnetisms. It doesn't matter which magnetism. How do you tell north from south or south from north? It doesn't matter, okay? I just want you to know there's three fields. Remember, one is when they pull together. I keep this one the same, I turn it around. There's two, and I twist them both around to flip the magnets, and I'll show you how to do this so you don't get confused. And here's three fields, okay? Magnetism is very easy to learn, but most people don't understand magnetism, okay? And you've seen a lot of little toys, like this one here, okay? Two magnets, and you throw them up in the air, and these things, they hit each other so fast, that's the vibration you're sounding. These are really good to be able to go running with, to be able to, remember, energy is gonna flow through you. You're not gonna get energy from these, okay, unless you're grounded, okay? You're gonna get flow through you. So you're not getting energy from these. In fact, if you put yourself on a DC meter, if you hold on to magnets all the time, what they do is they sort of draw your energy because they're pulling it, okay? So it depends on how much battery you have in your fluid. Your body's 18 gallons of salt water. How much conductivity do you have? How good is your battery to store energy? Remember, you get energy from the sun and light. You get energy also from food, magnetism. Remember, from minerals, that's conductivity. So these are all important parts. So remember, magnetism, we're going over this whole theme of this workshop here is to understand magnetism. And of course, you're gonna have to practice it. So I'm just showing you this. A lot of magnets are in toys. Remember, how does your alternator work? Remember, it's magnetism. Okay, how does anything that you see that actually is power generation, you'll see that they're using magnets on almost anything. How do you get an MRI, magnetic resonance imaging test, when let's say we wanted to check for a tumor or something? Okay, they're using magnetism. Nikola Tesla had over 1,000 patents, and a lot of his patents had to do with magnetism. And using the earth's energy, the silent energy. The same with also Townsend Brown, okay? These are all different types of researchers that was using invisible, okay? And let's just go over this one more time and then we're gonna go further because I want you to understand this. Remember, this is invisible energy. Hold this again, Beatrice. Again, look, it's invisible, but is it real?
It's very strong.
It's very strong, okay? Now you turn yours over. Remember, there's one field. I'm just gonna go through this one more time. Turn it one more, just like that. Okay, now here's another field, okay? That's two fields, okay? Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna flip our magnets around 180 degrees each, and there's the third field. Oops, sorry, now I get confused. But we'll mark these. Look, one field, you flip it over, two fields, okay? It's fighting, okay? Three fields, okay? North, north, let's say, south, south, and north, south. North, south pulls together, remember? Opposites attract in magnetism. So now let's just go over a couple other things. We're going to show you how to make three magnetisms in glass. Okay, and you're going to drink these with different fluids, because if you learn magnetism real quick, you'll understand. Okay, and when they don't teach this in school, because they don't want you really to know about microcurrents, and we've done previous videos on microcurrents, and microcurrents are used in your body to be able to paralyze microbes by using microcurrents. And these aren't just ideas, these are patents, okay? They're just not available for a lot of people to use. And magnetism can be used in many different ways. So another form of magnetism I want to show you is a magnetic generator, okay? And a magnetic generator is this little machine right here, and this is made by Soda Instruments. And this is the same form of a type of magnetism, but what we're gonna do, this is gonna be what's called static magnetism, and this is a weapon. This is called an EMP. It's a weapon to microbes. An electrical magnetic pulse weapon, I call it. And I turn this on, okay? Make sure. And you can see the little red light, okay? And every time it goes and hits the red and goes to the green, it's gonna fire off a shot at a million miles an hour. It stores energy in here just like a flash does, and then choo, it sends it out. Stores energy, boom, sends it out, okay? And it does this about 64 times, then you reset it. Let me show you what it looks like. Remember, magnetism is invisible. Can you feel this? Watch.
Not really.
Wait for it.
All she can hear is a click. Can't feel a thing. The invisible, but it's going right through her head, and it's actually hitting Stefan over there. You don't believe so. It's only because, remember, magnetism is silent. Silent. Okay, guys? So, let's understand this, how this works now. Look, you can see my magnetism here. Look, I've got a lodestone here, which is a meteorite, okay? This is all different types of magnets, which we're gonna use on the jars. And you can see that magnetism just flows from piece to piece. And if I take this piece off of here, look, it's even magnetized. Things. Magnetism is pretty special stuff.
It stays like that for a while.
It's magnetizing things even though these weren't magnetized before. That's why I want to show you. This is invisible energy. Okay, now watch this. So I'm going to put this right here and you can see. Watch, invisible. Bing! You shot at 10 feet. Okay, watch, invisible. Okay, but you can't see this. Okay, you can't feel it. All you can hear is a click. That's all you hear. Click. So this is to be used on the body. Remember, magnetism. How do you use this? That's another story. Okay, but I wanted to show you. This is an electrical magnetic pulse. Okay, so each one of these different types of magnetism are very special. Now, we'll go over how to use this specifically. Okay, this is a whole workshop in itself. How to use this correctly. And this is a very, very good weapon to have to be able to break down things that live in the lymph system, okay, that are hiding inside your lymph system. How do you get those out of your body? You can clean your blood really easy, but how do you get the dirt? How do you get the microbes, the pathogenic microbes out of your lymph? Remember, most of the diseases that people have are in the lymph system. So we're putting that over there. Now, I want to show you this also. This is, you can see here, it's very special stuff here. Okay, let me just get a couple magnets here, get a little more power. Okay, you can see how this dust is meteorite dust. And where do you get this? You can get this yourself. Look, I'm going to turn the magnets over. Everybody does what I want it to do. Look at that. Okay? Boom. Okay? So what we're going to use, we're going to use this also, okay, as part of the mattress. Remember, it's all complementing, but I just wanted to show you. This is meteorite dust, and where do you think you get this? You buy it? You can buy it for $10 a gram. It must be special for $10 a gram. Okay? You go to the beach. You bring a few magnets like this. If you can, you find a cove, okay? Every time a shooting star comes in or anything comes in from the planet there, it hits the ionosphere and you see shooting stars, you see the little lights, okay? And then those particles fall down in the ocean and they come to the Earth because the Earth's magnetic, okay? And so what you're doing is you're just picking up. Watch when I put this in here. This is what you do when you put it, you put this, here's what you do. You find the water, you try to find a cove if you can, because there's way more in a cove. I've done this for a long time. And I can get a pound of this material in an hour. And remember, it's a dollar or $10 a gram. You can watch a show called Meteorite Man, and you can see how much meteorites are worth. People go around the planet and they're trying to find meteorites, and they found one, and oh, we've just found one. It's this $3,000 piece. And it's actually, they say, illegal to be able to bring meteorites over a certain side between states for some odd reason. There must be something special about them. So what I do is I find the cove, and then it's wet right here. So I go back about 4 to 6 feet where the sand's dry. This doesn't work in the wet sand. You have to go back to the dry sand. I don't want to go way back there. It's because all the power is right here, right where the water hits the surf. And so I put my magnets in the sand, in white sand, and I pull everything I pull up. Watch, this is going to happen like this. Look. Everything I pull up is this beautiful stuff. What is this weird stuff? Look at it. And you notice how each particle stands up straight. So each one of these little particles, okay, are sort of what you could call like a miniature earth. So this stuff is very special. And I use this for health. I use this to make my plants grow like crazy.
They're standing on each other.
They stand on each other because I've already magnetized these guys too. And look, how do you even get them off? Look, they won't even come off. Look, how many I can pick up. Okay, so, and once you get this on here, how do you get it off? At the beach, you just go like this, and you just pull them off. And this is how you get yourself a pound of this material, and I would see if you can get about 10 pounds. You'd put this in your garden, because this stuff is magical in your garden, okay? So this is what I'd call meteorite dust. And meteorite dust, okay, like I said, you're not buying it. You just go to the beach. Pacific Ocean's loaded full of it. If you go to the beaches we have here, you can only find this in white sand beaches, because if you go to a black sand beach, some of the beaches here in Hawaii, the volcanic rock is magnetic, so you can't tell the difference. Okay, and that rock's good to put in your garden too, but I want this stuff. I want the super magnetic stuff. And you get that in quartz sand. So one last thing we're gonna do while we're doing this, okay, and also this is what we're gonna do too. Remember, we're also gonna go ahead and make, I'm gonna show you real quickly how to make a magnetic blender. Remember, this all is a work in progress, and I used to put the magnets down here at the bottom, and if you do, you'll burn your blender out. It's because it's too close to the armature, it's too close to the other magnets in the motor, and they sort of compete for energy, okay? So I got a little smarter now. I put them up higher, I've gone through several Vitamixes, so buy your Vitamix at Costco in case it goes down, you just take it back, keep your box. So we're gonna show you how to make one of these, and why would you make a magnetic blender? You ever use one?
Magnetize your dream.
Not only magnetize, but what does it do?
Breaks things down.
It breaks them down and blends them. So what this does is this thing spins at a very high speed. It only works on high though. On low it doesn't work, the magnets. And it spins it in a vortex. And what it does with the magnetize the form that we put on. We're putting on the multi-form of the magnetism. I'll show you how to put this on here. It doesn't work unless you use the magnets in this format though. Okay, it's got to be a multiplex format. And so let's say we put oil and water. Okay, and you buy Bernstein salad dressing. What do? You have to shake it up real fast and pour it out real quick. If not, what does it do? Separates again. So I've done many. I was going to take a patent out for this. Okay, I call it the super blender, nano blender. You put this Bernstein's in there, you blend it for 30 seconds, it'll never separate ever again, is because what we do is we broke down all the magnetic bonds of fat to water to everything, and we homogenized everything and everything. And the secret thing to put in there to make it do that is, what do you think? What is one of the dissolving agents we use on our skin to get rid of wrinkles?
Fulvic.
Okay, what does fulvic do? Disassociate. So when you add a few things like this, now all of a sudden the magic occurs. So you can take oil and water, and mix it together here. And you'll get a stable homogenization, okay? So everything will go ahead and blend together. So I'll show you how to make one of those. And last thing, while we're here, okay, we went over how to make copper. Because you're gonna use copper. Remember, this goes on your bed. And remember, you're really trying to sanitize your bed. And one of the things you're gonna put on your bed and your pillows and everything else, okay, is copper that you're gonna make. You're gonna spray that into your pillowcases. You're gonna spray it on your bed, okay? And the reason I'm telling you this is because we're gonna put this on a board, so this is gonna be Bernadette's, gonna be her portable mattress where you could take this and put it anywhere. You could take it out in the sun with you and stretch on it. You can do a lot of different things, or you could change it from bed to bed. I have mine on my bed that I've put down permanently, okay? And my bed's big enough to be able to make it, because the reason why you put it on a board sometimes, if you're sleeping on a small bed, because sometimes you're gonna have to not be able to sleep on this because this thing's too powerful. You're gonna have to stop, okay? I know it takes sometimes 2 weeks and my back starts to dissolve. And I wake up in the morning and I have urine, foam this big, okay? From all the calcification and all the different garbage that comes out. You wake up and your face is swollen. You need to drink a lot of water, a lot of what kind of water? That's what I'm gonna show you next. Remember, you're gonna break down all these microbes. Just because you lay on this thing here, you're gonna cause at night a revolution in your body. When do your yeast, mold, fungus, candida, and most of your microbes replicate?
Night.
When does Dracula come out? Okay, so what are you gonna do? You're gonna stop them from feeding. Why? Because you're putting super magnetism in. They don't like magnetism. I know that. So I've done all these experiments with plants. I've put plants, just like I'm gonna show you, with North. Plants grow okay. I put other ones, I did with tobacco, because tobacco is really easy to manipulate. I did other ones with South. They do okay too. But if I use the biphasic electricity and give them a little bit of everything, they flourish, okay? And it's not just the magnetism that they get, but the microbes that live, that are bad, pathogenic microbes, can't navigate for some reason. It doesn't affect the good ones because the plant grows better than any of the other plants. Now, I also have used, like I said, is the meteorite dust in the plants, and that's the easiest and simplest and freest thing you can do, and you put it in your soil and it makes your whole plant system propagate. Okay, that's why it's really good to put volcanic ash, they say, is because it does have, it has magnetism component plus minerals. You think this has minerals in it? You bet you it does. What kind? Well, it doesn't rust into the ocean. They're very special. This is iron oxide, but it's been seared by coming into the ionosphere with high heavy heat. One other way that this is made, and I've got a lot of stones that I've bought from here, is this is meteorite, very hard to find, okay? But what I found is I found a person that I could go ahead and buy not meteorite from, because it's the same thing, but it's called lodestone. You know what lodestone means? This is, remember, all the old boys, Newton, Copernicus, everybody's using them. How do you think they went ahead and made, what do they call them? Compasses, okay? Lodestone is made by having high electrical lightning hit the ground with special rocks. It pulls it down because it's magnetism, the electricity, and it fries this thing. You can see how the end of this thing, that was fried. Look how smooth that is right here. So I've got pieces from this guy, about 100 pounds, okay? And I'm gonna show you how I've used these. These are magical to use with you. Remember, magnetism is gonna help you regenerate. You're just gonna have to experiment with it. The older you are, the more this is actually gonna give you side effects. It's because you have more calcification, you have more oxalate poisoning. It's gonna soften things up and your back's gonna go out. Ooh, and when it does, well, that's normal. And you better get off the mattress. You better start drinking a ton of fluids, and you need to really wash out your body every morning. This is one of the tricks I found out by doing this. Remember, it's not just laying on this magnet. What are you gonna do with all the dead microbes? Remember, when I wake up in the morning, I have foam this big, and the foam is bubbly, okay? And it's sort of not even yellow, it's cloudy. I wake up in the middle of the night sweating, okay? Not sweating, sweating. I wake up in the middle of the night and I get cramps in my legs, and this happens on and off for the first few months. This is what I found to be normal. But when these things happen and it bothers you, and it's not just cramps, I gotta get out of bed. And I gotta walk around and go, wow, okay? It's not just something I can go move around and it doesn't, no. Okay, so this is going to cause a little havoc. So let's say you had a low back injury or a shoulder injury. In time, those are going to start to soften up. Okay, and what's going to happen? It's going to hurt. My shoulder, I had a real bad shoulder accident from throwing balls. I could really throw balls far, and I had a bad shoulder accident falling off a bicycle. And I couldn't throw a ball for like 2 years. My shoulder was really dumb. Okay, and that was when I was 13 years old. Well, when I started laying on the mattress, my shoulder started to dissolve. And I was probably 45 years old, maybe 47 years old when I started to first do this. About 44 years old. And my shoulder, I couldn't move it for about 3 months. I had to put my fingers up on the wall to be able to get it up. Everything inside started to dissolve. And I found out if that happens to you, you need to massage it, and you really need to move those muscles around. Think of the joints. If they're stuck and they're calcified and they're stuck and you start softening them up, do you think the muscles, ligaments, and tendons that were holding those joints together were moving? No, they're calcified too. And they don't know how to move. And so all of a sudden this starts to move and there's nothing holding them. And you get they're sharp pains. So you need to ice it right away if this happens to you. And I'm not going to say if it happens to you, when it happens to you, because it will, especially older people. These young bucks over here, younger people, and she's not that young, she's 40, okay, close to 60. But even her at 40 years old, she hurt herself when she was 15, falling off of bicycles, maybe getting into an auto accident, whatever it is, okay? These are the calcification. Maybe, let's say you have kidney stones. What do you think this is going to do to you? It's going to slowly dissolve them. That's one of the reasons you get this big foam, because whatever it's doing, it's dissolving. So what I use is I use an ozone generator, okay? And if you don't have an ozone generator, you can use some food-grade hydrogen peroxide, okay? Food-grade hydrogen peroxide. This is an ozone generator, and you never want to breathe this, okay? This is made for making ozonated water, and just turn it on. You can see how it bubbles, and it's got a little pump in here. And you don't breathe that coming out of there. This has ozone, but it also has nitrates. So what you do is you sort of cover this up a little bit just to be able to make it so the concentration of ozone can stay in there. And you put this in another room for about 15 minutes. And as soon as it's done, you don't go in the room and breathe anything. You go in and grab it. Don't breathe the air. Keep the window open in there. So if any of the it's not the ozone that sort of burns you too much. It's the nitrosamines that actually is burned also in here. If you want pure ozone, you have to use pure oxygen, okay? Like you're using, Shanti, okay? So right now we're using the air. Ambient air has 79% nitrogen and 20% oxygen, so it's cracking everything in there, okay? So any of the nitrates that come out of there will burn your lungs. So you have to be very careful. I used to think this was good for me, and it burned my lungs. And it doesn't just burn it for a day or two. You're gonna, 6 months, okay? I've had problems, okay? Because I didn't understand where it was coming from. I thought I got like some type of, well, this was a long time. This is 15 years. Like I said, I'm showing you guys some secrets. You can figure it out yourself, okay? 15 minutes, and as soon as this is done, what do? Put it back in the refrigerator? No, you drink it immediately, because in 5 minutes, the ozone's gone. It's concentrated in there for a few minutes. You can take this now, really smart. You can make coconut oil, ozonated coconut oil. Very smart, okay? You can use a lot of different things. You can do olive oil, okay? And people sell this stuff. So I just put this in there for about 15 minutes, and this is gonna do what? What's ozone gonna do? What does it do? It oxidizes. Okay, so if you have dead critters inside your body, what are you gonna do? Better oxidize them, okay? You can taste it already. Okay, so I'm gonna start out first thing, and then we'll start doing this. Part two, I'm gonna show you how to do all these different things. This is for Earther Academy. Part one was I just wanted to show you some of the things we're gonna do. Also, this is a magnetic headdress. It looks sort of foolish, okay, but this really changes the organization of your brain. Your brain is electrical, magnetic, and chemical, okay? And each one of these has biphasic energy, north, south, north, south, north, south, and each one has a crystal. And this is made for the size of my head, sort of dorky, and you put this on and keep it on as long as you can handle it. And you'll feel dizzy and you'll start to go ahead and feel sort of weird, maybe even a little nauseated, so then take it off, okay? If you're gonna put it on for a few minutes, turn it around and change the magnetism around. What you're trying to do is change a lot of the magnet. You can wear this around your neck. You can put this on your shoulder if you have a bad shoulder, okay? You got a bad hip, put it on your hip. You can put it anywhere you want. You can even sit on this. You got prostate problems, sit on it. Magnetism is your friend, okay? Biphasic magnetism, and I'm gonna show you. Everything we're gonna do is biphasic. That's health related. Why?
So you put magnet underneath the crystals?
Yeah, underneath here, see this flexible mat here, we'll show you how to make one of these. So I call this the Merlin. Why? Because it does make you smart, okay? The Merlin, it's a magnetic energy ring, and I call it a linear infusion neutralizer. It neutralizes all your BS in your brain, okay? It's reprogramming your magnetism in your brain to make it so maybe you can actually upgrade, enhance, and optimize. Why? Because your programs now have been sort of scrambled, and you didn't do anything. All you did was scramble around a lot of the iron. Remember, iron's in your body. Is iron magnetism? Okay, how about heavy metals in your brain? How about different types of magnetism that's stuck in there? How about just move it around so you can see if you can get it out? You don't move it around, you're not getting it out. Okay, that's why headstands are really important. That's why a lot of the stuff, but magnetism softens it up. Can't do a headstand because your head's gonna explode. It's because your brain's full of brain sand. And this helps dissolve brain sand. Kidney stones, all these different things. But it's also a diet and it's also a protocol. It's not just this stuff. It's not magical by itself. Just like water fasting you guys are doing. It's not so much magical by itself. It's a combination of everything, including rest, including seeing green all the time, including doing far infrared sauna, colon cognitive therapies, IV there, all the stuff, and whatever else you wanted to do. Okay, so underneath here is a magnetic tape, and you get this at Home Depot, and it's about a half inch, comes in a 25-foot roll, and I measured my head, and I wrapped it around, sort of sticks together, and then I tied my magnets to here. But I'd have to show you how to do this, but this is all simple. The format I'm showing you, remember, is to be switched on anything you want to do. Let's say you want to put magnetism on your water. What are you going to do? You're going to put the full magnetism coming out of your shower. Don't you think that would be smart? Yeah, it's nice to get magnetized water because it's not magnetized going through pumps. It's not magnetized going through 150 miles of pressured pipes. Okay, it's lost its structure. So how do you get back its structure? Magnetize it. But it's not just north-north magnetism or south. You put them all on. So next thing we're going to do here, and then we'll start, okay? I'm going to make copper. While we're doing this, I'm just going to show you, we already went on and did a workshop on this. And before you do the copper anytime, you always clean the copper or the metal just to get off any oxidation or any garbage on there. And then the contacts on the top, right, because these slide through in and out, just roll them back and forth to make sure that the contacts are really good. Because if the contacts don't work, they don't work. We're just going to use distilled water. Distilled water is the best way to make this because the copper is going to be pure. If you put minerals in there, the more minerals you put in, the more colloids, the more separate things. Let's say minerals are 80 minerals in there. You've got vanadium in there. You've got molybdenum in there, 80 minerals. You don't really want to make copper with those minerals, okay? If you want to do that, you're making it because you want speed. It takes about an hour and a half to make copper, just like it does, you can make silver in distilled water, but it takes a long time because the conductivity is very low. So what I do is I put one drop of magnesium in here is because I'm a little impatient and I know it works just as good, one drop. So all I do is, this is distilled water, just to show you real quick here. Okay, and we pulled this out and this says 000. And let's see, what does that say? You tell them, Bernadette, what does that say?
200.
No, no.
Oh, two.
002.
002.
Okay, so that's had 002 particles in it, nothing. Okay, so what are we gonna do? Do you have any minerals here? Just gonna put one drop. That's it. You can put one drop of sole salt. You can put one drop of magnesium. Okay. Yeah, that's perfect. Any one of those. So you can either use this as inland sea salt. These are all conductive. Remember, I showed you guys last time how the light bulb works. And all I'm gonna do is I put two or three drops in there. I only want one though. And all we do is give it a mix. And now I'm gonna check its parts per million one more time. And you wanna really mix it good because if not, the machine won't pick up the parts per million. And now we're going to put it in again. Okay.
148, 150.
Okay. Look at, I just put a few drops in it. Now you have 150 parts per million, 157, right?
Mm-hmm.
157. So right here, 157, and we want to make a 100 part per million solution. Okay. Because I can dilute that down and then I can use it topically like we want to use on both you guys. You want to use topical solutions, you use 50 parts per million to 100 parts per million. That's what I use. If you want to take it internally, okay, and of course, do it at your own risk. Look up the research and you'll see that this is a very highly restorative, regenerative thing to have copper in your system for antifungal, for anti-wrinkles, for anti-gray, for a lot of anti-aging. And copper is very special. It was used in Egypt. It was used in the old time. Back then, what do you think they did when you got sick? What do you think they did when you got an injury? They used copper. Okay, remember we showed you, you could make copper salicylates with aspirin with this, you could make copper citrate with this, okay? You can make copper ascorbate with this. You can push it in further with DMSL. Okay, so let's go here.
So how many parts per million for internal application?
10. Yeah, you just want 10. You want slow amounts, but you want to do it 2 or 3, 4 times a day, little bits at a time. Little bits at a time. And you'll find out that this is probably the most unknown physical element that's actually missing in people. It's way more powerful than silver is. And the most unknown unphysical element is what? Magnetism. It's unknown. It's because it's invisible. No one talks about it. Remember, you saw it here, you felt it here. It's invisible. Remember, it's here, it's right here, it's right here, but you don't see it. But look, something's holding all this garbage together. Something. It's free. Something's holding it together. You know how you make one of these here? Why do you think you take boron inside your body? Because this has got cobalt and boron, and boron's an essential for you to have magnetism. Remember, you want magnetism? We have to let you sort of absorb the magnetism first, just like the sun. You have to learn how to absorb plasma. Your body doesn't know how to do it because it doesn't really have a lot of it, and it doesn't have the battery to hold the charge. Remember, you can take your battery in your car, and once we get this philosophy down there, you get it. If not, you just lost. You got a battery, and all of a sudden your car doesn't start, and you charge it for 8 hours on whatever, 2 hours, whatever it takes to go ahead and charge it, but it won't hold charge. It's because the liquid inside has lost its capacity to hold charge. So a brand new battery has the capacity to hold charge. When the batteries are brand new, they don't even have any. They charge them. The magnets, they have the capacity to make. Once I magnetize it, it's magnetized forever. It's because this is an energy here that actually takes energy from right here. It's right here, but we can't feel it. It's in here, but we can't feel it. So this is what you have to do, is you have to slowly become more conductive to magnetism. And that means you need boron in your system. Okay, you don't want cobalt, but these are made by boron and cobalt, 1100 degrees. You magnetize them, and wow, look, I mean, that's pretty heavy. Those are heavy, and it's held by that one in between that's really wimpy. Okay, that's strong, strong magnetism. Okay, so we turn this on like this. We know it's at 157 parts, and that's it. Okay, how to use this, of course, is turn this guy on. I actually got to plug it in. Too many things plugged in here. This one's right. That's why it's not plugged in. Okay. Okay, we got light now. And you can see the light's on right now. And remember, all we have is a very small amount. And all I want to do is make sure that the rods don't touch each other. And it's starting to bubble already. Little tiny bubbles. That just means we have conductivity. So I'm going to put this over here. And we'll check that later. This is going to take at least an hour to make 30 or 40 parts. Silver is way easier to make than copper as far as the time it does, because silver is a lot softer. Okay, gold is really takes a long time to make. Okay, I make gold too. You need a different generator and you need more power. Okay, platinum, they use an arc platinum generator, and that's made underwater and you make vapor with it. That's another whole other thing, and I've used that for about a month. You have to be really an experimenter to play around with platinum. Platinum, remember, is used to make your body turn into more of a hydrogen engine. How do they make hydrogen? Do you know? With platinum. How do they make alkaline water machines? Platinum plates. You know that? And they always say, I got big platinum plates. We have 7 platinum plates. Platinum, not 10. Platinum. Okay, how do they make electrolysis for cars? Okay, for all these hybrids. This is how they have on-demand platinum. It's platinum that they use. That's why platinum is so expensive. It's not for your rings. That's all dumb. People wear jewelry, remember, that's not using the platinum metal groups for what they're made for. These are alchemy metals. Okay, so that's it for part one. Okay, so let's go ahead and shut this down and we'll go do part two. Okay, here we go, part two, and we've got ourselves an assistant here because you need an assistant to do this. If you don't do this with another person, you have to be very careful. Again, unprotected magnets are dangerous, and you should wear goggles doing this, is because if I pull these together really hard, okay, and snap them, these are very brittle, and a piece, like I said, can go into your eye. I've had one shoot into my neck, and I pulled it out of my neck, and I said, whoa, if that went in my eye like that, and finally it did. So I don't play with these by themselves. And you can see Trevor put some tape around these. So now that they're safe. So what we're gonna do on these, and you can see how I've already done this. These magnets came off my old bed. Okay? When I moved here, I took them all off. And I mark these like this. Remember, it doesn't mean north, south. You can use one or two. We just want to know one side from the other side. You can see how this side says zero. Okay? And, well, this one used to say something else, but this used to say an X. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to mark X on one side.
Important reminder, all information and ideas are for informational purposes only and are in no way intended as medical advice or as a substitute for medical counseling. Earthshift Products, Dr. Robert Cassar, all of their partners, affiliates, and subsidiaries will not be held accountable for the use or misuse of the information presented therein. This information is not intended as medical advice. The authors, publishers, and speakers of this work are not medical doctors and do not recommend the use of mineral-deficient foods, drugs, or medicines to achieve beauty and to alleviate health challenges. Because there is always some risk involved, all persons involved with the development and distribution of this information are not responsible for any adverse effects or consequences of any kind resulting from the use or misuse of any suggestions or procedures described on our website or Earthshift Live radio talk show or therein.